Assalamu alaikum dear friends, I am Sajid Ali. In this lecture we are going to discuss about Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was the third son of Shah Jahan and he ascended throne in 1659. He was born in October 1618 at Dohat. Dohat is the region of Gujarat and dear friends, he ascended throne after two battles, the battle of Dharmat and Samugad, after defeating his brother Dara. Dara was liberal but he was theocratic at that time also, and when he ascended throne he started introduce some theocratic policies which were against other religions, because he was an extremist ruler in the history of Mughal as well as in the history of subcontinent. And dear friends, due to his policies, so many communities became against Aurangzeb as well as Mughal Empire. And the revolt of Jats, it was the first revolt of Hindus against Mughal Empire. And dear friends, in subcontinent it was Hindu majority living. Muslims were not native, they came from different areas, Central Asia, Arabs, Afghanistan and other areas. They were native, they were not native of the subcontinent India, but they ruled many years over the Hindus and Muslims. So before Aurangzeb, rest of the rulers of Mughal Empire were not so extremist. They introduced such policies which were not against other religions as Akbar. That's why in the Mughal army and in other departments there were majority of Hindus working, and they were not against Mughal Empire. And also dear friends, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, and Akbar and Jahangir, they rulers also married with Rajput princes. So dear friends, they were most liberal rulers. But Aurangzeb was not liberal. When the revolts of Jats started, Gokul was the leader of Jats, and behind the revolts of Jats was the destroying of temples. When Aurangzeb started destroying temples of Hindus, Jats rebelled against Aurangzeb. After Gokul, Raja Ram became the leader of Jats. He was also against Aurangzeb, and the last chairman who fought against Aurangzeb till the death of Aurangzeb, Setnamis, the revolt of Setnamis. The major causes of behind the revolt of Setnamis was the misunderstanding between Mughal army and peasants of Setnamis peasants. So Mughal army was so cruel at that time, it was against Setnamis. That's why Setnamis revolted against Aurangzeb. Sikh community, they also became rebellion at the time of Aurangzeb. And Guru Tegh Bahadur, who was the ninth guru of Sikh community from 1664 to 1675, Guru Tegh Bahadur was killed by Aurangzeb. After Guru Tegh Bahadur, Guru Gobind Singh, who was the 10th Guru of Sikh community from 1675 to 1708. So, Guru Gobind Singh became the Guru of Sikh community. Sikh community was under the leadership of their Guru, according to their religion. But Guru Gobind Singh ended the seat of Guru before his death. And Guru Gobind Singh made Sikh community as an army to protect themselves and face their enemies. So, dear friends, Dakhan was a vast area of subcontinent. In Dakhan, three states, Bidar, Ahmednagar, Berar. These three states were under Aurangzeb. But Bijapur and Golconda were not under the Aurangzeb. And there was majority of Shia community living in both two states, Bijapur and Golconda. Aurangzeb was also against Shia community, Shiaism. He wanted to crush them. That's why he occupied these states. Marathas was the great power of Dakhan. Aurangzeb tried to crush Marathas till his death, but he failed. Marathas were the extreme enemies of Aurangzeb. Shivaji was the first leader of Marathas. Then Shambhuji, his son, and the last Sahu. Sahu fought till the death of Aurangzeb. Sahu was in prison. He was arrested by Aurangzeb. So the revolt of Yusufzai is the tribe of Pashtun. They became rebellion under the leadership of Muhammad Shah. Revolt of Afridis, they were Pathans. They were under the leadership of Kamal Khan. And revolt of Khatak, they were also Pathans under the leadership of Khushhal Khan Khatak. So, dear friends, Aurangzeb also launched so many laws and policies which were against Hindus. He started destroying temples and he reimposed jizya and also banned on Hindu festivals, just like Holi, Diwali and other Hindu festivals. He was totally against Hindus and other non-Muslims. That's why Viscount Smith, a great writer, says about Aurangzeb that the Dakhan is not only the grave of Aurangzeb but also his empire. So, dear friends, and other many writers also says about the empire, about the time period of Aurangzeb, that the Aurangzeb was the major reason behind the declination of Mughal empire, because he created only enemies. His policies were against non-Muslims, so he could not rule over India properly, is Akbar, Jahangir and Shah Jahan. They were liberal and rational, and they thought that it was the a need of time to patch up Hindus because they were in majority, but Aurangzeb did not do so. That's why he failed, and he created to fall Mughal Empire. So dear friends, Aurangzeb died in 1707. After the death of Aurangzeb, the remaining rulers could not run their governments so many years and in a strong way. They could not control properly because Aurangzeb created enemies. They just evolved to face their enemies. So dear friends, inshallah, in my next lecture we will discuss the declination of Mughal Empire. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.